Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install PHPStorm IDE in your understand operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing PHPStorm IDE in your understand operating system, let us first understand what this IDE basically does. Now, PHPStorm, as the name suggests, is basically used by mainly PHP developers. So, if you are a PHP developer or basically you are a web developer, then it is a very good IDE. And it is also extensively used for, you know, developing WordPress plugins. So, let us see how you can download and install PHPStorm IDE. So for that, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in here just need to simply type PHPStorm download. Then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on this download PHPStorm. And this will then automatically going to redirect you to this official site of PHPStorm. So in here you can clearly see that they have this PHPStorm for Windows, macOS and Linux. In this video I'm going to show you how to install PHPStorm for Windows, and you can also clearly see that PHPStorm includes an evaluation license key for 30-day free trial. So this is a paid software, so you need to pay a certain amount to buy their license key. But if you are a student or a teacher, then you don't need to worry about the license key. All you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply open a new tab and just, you know, simply type student developer pack, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this education.github.com. So just, you know, simply go inside that link, and here all you need to do is you need to just simply sign up over here. And then you need to just, you know, simply click on this get your pack. I have already made a video about how you can get your student developer pack. So you know, just follow that video and you'll be able to access this JetBrains. So you'll be getting this benefit of a free subscription for students, which is basically, you know, you can also renew it annually. And the same thing you can do if you are a teacher. So after that, you'll be getting a license key, and all you need to do is you need to just simply use that license key for using the software beyond your 30-day trial. But in this video I'm going to show you how you can download and how I can but in this video I'm going to show you how you can download and how you can use that software. So for that, all you need to do is you need to just simply click on this download button, and this will automatically going to start downloading your PHPStorm. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this PHPStorm version 2021.1.3 has been rightly downloaded over here. So for installation, all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply double clicking on it and just, you know, minimize our download directory. And then you need to give your administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you can clearly see our PHPStorm setup wizard has been directly opened. For installation, just simply click on next. So this is going to be, you know, your installation destinations where this PHPStorm is going to be installed, and you need to have at least 1.1 gigabyte of free space in your C directory. Currently I am having 39.8 gigabyte of free space in my C directory, so it will not create any problem. So you need to, you know, simply check all this and then just, you know, simply click on next. And this will automatically show this installation options window. In here, you need to just simply click on this 64-bit launcher. If you are using 32-bit launcher, then you need to simply proceed with that link. And, you know, just simply add this launcher to directory path. So this will, you know, going to help you to set your environment path automatically at the system variable. So, you know, just simply check that and just simply add your open folder as project, so that you can, you know, just simply right click on it and you'll be able to see your PHPStorm over there. And as mentioned earlier, it is used for PHP, then PHHTML, then .js, .cs and .html. So just simply check all this and you know just simply click on next. And it's now currently saying that they're going to create this JetBrains folder. So inside that folder they're going to install your PhpStorm. So for installation just simply click on install and this will you know going to start your installation. You can always click on the show details and you can see that how the installation is actually happening. So it will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing PhpStorm. Yeah, so we'll come back and now you can clearly see our PhpStorm setup has been directly completed and it's now currently telling that whether we want to you know reboot now or we want to manually reboot later. So I want to reboot my machine later. So for that just you know simply check this I want to manually reboot later and you know just simply click on finish. And then you'll be seeing this PhpStorm 2021.1.3 version has been directly installed and our desktop icon has also been created. So now just simply double click on it to launch our PhpStorm IDE. And you can clearly see our PhpStorm IDE has been directly launched. Currently it's telling that whether we'd like to import our settings. So I don't want to you know import our settings. So just simply click on OK. And it has you know rightly opened our license activation window. So as mentioned earlier, after getting your developer account from here, you'll be able to get a license number. So all you need to do is you need to just you know simply paste that license number over here. So do paste your license number over here and you know then you need to just simply click on activate and it will you know going to activate. In this video I'm going to show you a simple you know 30-day trial. So for that I'm just you know simply going to check all this and then you know simply giving our email address. And you know then simply click on evaluate. So it's now currently telling that I have 30 days left for you know to use PhpStorm. Then you know simply click on continue. And then after a moment your you know PhpStorm is going to be launched and it's now currently telling that welcome to PhpStorm. So just you know simply maximize it and let us first create a new project. So after clicking this new project you will be getting this many options. So you can right away create your Vue project or React Native or a React project just you know simply clicking off a button. Similarly you can create for Node.js project and HTML5 boilerplate you will be also getting by just a single click. And similarly you will be able to create your Angular CLI project, Angular.js project and Bootstrap project and also Express project. So you can create all this project by you know just a single click. In this video, I'm going to show you a simple PHP project. So for it, you know, just simply select this PHP empty project and then you need to give a project name over here. So let's give a project name as a PHP-demo. And you know, then simply click on create. And this will, you know, going to create your PHP demo project. It's now currently preparing our workspace. So you can clearly see our PHP demo project has been directly created. And now showing the tip of the disk, so for the time being just you know, simply click on close. So let us create a new file over here. So go to file, then new PHP file. And you need to give your PHP file name over here. So let's give a file name as prog1 and you know then just simply click on OK. And this will you know going to create your prog1 PHP file. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be you know just simply echoing hello world in our console. So hello world, then simply end with a semicolon and then all you need to do is you need to just you know simply clicking on this browser icon. So let us open our program to our browser. So for that just you know simply click on our Chrome button. And now it's telling that our Windows firewall has blocked some of the features. So, you know, just simply check this private network and then allow access. And then if you just simply reload it, you'll be still getting this 502 bad gateway. So all this means is your PHP interpreter is not set. So you'll be getting this pop-up over here. So you need to just, you know, simply clicking on this configure PHP interpreter. So here you need to add your CLI PHP interpreter. So for that, just simply click on this browse button, and then just simply click on add, and then you'll be getting this program files PHP 8.0.6. So just simply check that, and then just simply click on OK. Then again OK, and then if you just again go to your browser, and if you just reload it, you'll be getting Hello World in your console. But the thing is, you need to first install PHP. So if you check my system, if I just simply go to my C directory and then program files, you'll be seeing this PHP 8.0.6 has been rightly installed. So for that, I have already made a video on this video called how to install PHP 8.0.6 on your Windows 10. So if you just simply open that video, so it's now currently showing here. So all you need to do is you need to watch this video called how to install PHP 8.0.6 on your Windows 10. So there I have clearly mentioned how you can install your PHP on your system. So do watch that video, and then you'll be seeing this PHP 8.0.6 over here. So after that, you can easily add in your PhpStorm IDE. I'll be also putting this link of this video in the description, so you don't need to worry about the link and all. So you'll be getting the link right at the description. So all you need to do is you need to first install this PHP 8.0.6, and then you can easily add that by the method that I have just shown. And then you need to just simply clicking on this browser, and you'll be able to see your output right at your browser. So if you just simply change this to Hello World to Hello Geeky Script, and then just again simply click on this browser button, you can clearly see this Hello Geeky Script has been rightly shown in our browser. So that's basically all about this video. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do also check our website geekyscript.com. So that's basically all about this video. I have rightly shown you how to install PhpStorm IDE in your Windows 10 operating system, and then I have also shown you a simple demo PHP code snippet and how to run them. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also do share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.